गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट ऑफ क्लास फोर, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर फिट एंड हेल्दी। सो स्टूडेंट, टुडे डेट इज 16 एंड आई एम टीचिंग यू चैप्टर नंबर 16। नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज आवर सराउंडिंग्स। सो स्टूडेंट, टेक आउट योर बुक, ओपन पेज नंबर 97। टेक आउट योर बुक एंड ओपन पेज नंबर 97। सो स्टूडेंट, लेट डू रिकैप्चुलेशन व्हाट वी हैव डन इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो। सो स्टूडेंट, इन प्रीवियस वीडियो we have completed the book exercise of chapter 16, question number A, tick the correct option. These are MCQ questions and for one answer there are four options are given and we have to choose the right option. So question number 1, that is A, tick the correct answer. We have already completed in our book. Now let us start with question number B, that is fill in the blanks. Question number 1, we must keep our surroundings dash. So student, when I have already explained you that we always take care of our personal hygiene and what is the reason to keep ourselves fit and healthy. Okay, then we discuss about the domestic hygiene. Daily you see your mother all the time she clean the house, so that the people living or members living inside the house that are fit and healthy. In the same manner student, we have to keep our surrounding also clean. If the surroundings are not clean, then the people living in that area will suffer from lot of different types of diseases. Because student, many times we go out from the house, so we must keep our surrounding clean so that we are fit and healthy student. Okay, so that we are fit and healthy. So what is the right answer? We must keep our surrounding clean. Let's discuss question number 2. Mosquitoes breeding in So student, at the time when we are talking about the surroundings and when we are talking about the personal hygiene of the houses, at that time we have already discussed that there should be no stagnant water in the house or in the surrounding. So if there is a standing water, it means that water do not flow. Okay, have you seen the river water? It flows. But stagnant water do not flow. That is the reason we say it as a stagnant water. So inside the houses, you always take care that your coolers, when it is a winter season, there should be no water in the cooler and other things inside the house in which the water can be collected, because these stagnant water places, these are the breeding, because these stagnant water is the breeding place of the mosquitoes. Yahan pe machhar paida hote hain, theek hai, unki breeding place hai ye. Is it clear? So and you will suffer from different types of a diseases with the bite of these mosquitoes. So student, don't allow stagnant water inside your house also and in your surroundings also. Is it clear? Because this is the breeding place of many mosquitoes. So mosquito breeding in stagnant water causes, answer is malaria. Only one blank is given, that is the reason I have written malaria. If there are two or blanks are given, you can also write dengue is also caused due to the bite of a mosquito. But in this question there is only one blank is given, that is the reason I have written only malaria. By chance, if this question come in the examination and if you write dengue, then also the answer is right. Is it clear? So no confusion. Third question. So question number 3, DAS is a process of burning waste in a big furnaces. ठीक है, DAS is a process सो स्टूडेंट क्वेश्चन इज ए डैश इज अ प्रोसेस ऑफ बर्निंग वेस्ट इन अ बिग फर्नेसेस, व्हाट इज इट नोन एज? ओके स्टूडेंट, व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द सॉलिड वेस्ट देन वी डिस्कस डिफरेंट मेथड ऑफ डिस्पोजल ऑफ दिस सॉलिड वेस्ट. तो आउट ऑफ दैट दिस इज ऑल्सो वन मैथड बाई विच यू कैन डू डिस्पोजल ऑफ द सॉलिड वेस्ट. वन मैथड इज थ्रोइंग गार्बेज इन द ओपन एरिया डेट इज वेरी फार अवे फ्रॉम द टाउन्स और सिटीज. एंड नेक्स्ट मैथड विच वी डिस्कस इन सॉलिड वेस्ट डिस्पोजल डेट इज द बर्न द वेस्ट. सी बाई बर्निंग द वेस्ट इट इज इफ यू थिंक सो वेन वी बर्न द थिंग्स स्टूडेंट देन द थिंग्स चेंज इन टू द ऐश. जब हम चीजों को जलाते हैं तो उसकी क्या बन जाती है? राख बन जाती है. ऐश उसको इंग्लिश में बोलते हैं. तो आपको लगता होगा कि कूड़े के बड़े से बड़े ढेर हैं, जलाने से एक छोटा सा ढेर रह जाता है और पूरे गार्बेज क्या होती है, कंप्लीटली खत्म हो जाती है. तो आप सोचते होंगे दिस मैथड इज द बेस्ट मैथड. ओके बट स्टूडेंट दिस इज नॉट द सेफ मैथड. बर्निंग ऑफ द वेस्ट ऐसा किया जाता है, वेस्ट को बर्न करते हैं फर्नेसेस में, बट दिस इज ऑल्सो नॉट ए वेरी सेफ मैथड बिकॉज बाई बर्निंग दिस गार्बेज लॉट ऑफ हार्मफुल गैसेस आर प्रोड्यूस्ड. एंड देन व्हाट्स हैपन, दीज हार्मफुल गैसेस मिक्सेस विद द एयर एंड इट क्रिएट्स ए न्यू प्रॉब्लम एंड दैट इज नोन एज एयर पॉल्यूशन. इज इट क्लियर? नाउ द प्रोसेस ऑफ बर्निंग वेस्ट इन बिग फर्नेस इज नोन एज इंसिनरेटर्स, इज नोन एज इंसिनरेटर्स. So note down the answer from the board and even you can take a screenshot also. Question number 4. Composed pits generate dash which can be used in fields. So, compost pits generate dash which can be used in field. So, this is also a method by which we can dispose, we do the disposal of solid waste. And which type of a solid waste? That is biodegradable. That is biodegradable. So in this method what we do student, we dug the pits in the ground. हम जमीन में गड्ढे खोदते हैं and after that in that pits we put the biodegradable waste and with this we also put the cow dung also and after that we cover this with the soil and left it for 4-5 months. After that again we dug the pit and what material is in that pit, we take it out. And after 4-5 months, after decay, it change in the form of a manure. It change in the form of a manure, जिसे हम क्या बोलते हैं बेटा, खाद बोलते हैं. And this manure is used by the farmer in the fields. Now the question arises, why farmers spread manure in the fields? Because these manure increase the fertility of the soil. Soil को क्या उपजाऊ बना देती हैं, जिससे the production of the crop is increase. Due to that, the production of the crop increases. So the right answer is manure. Okay, now question number 5. Now see student, fifth is dash R lead underground. So dash are laid underground. You know the drain pipes and sewage pipes. ठीक है, जिसमें आपका घर का जो जितना भी वेस्ट वाटर होता है या डर्टी वाटर होता है, और जो वाटर आपके टॉयलेट से आता है और बाथरूम से जो वाटर कलेक्ट होता है, so all these water goes underground with the help of a pipelines. Is it clear? All this water comes out of the houses with the help of the pipeline. Is it clear? Okay, after completing this, let's start with a new question, that is question number C. Match the following. Now see the next question is match the following.
फर्स्ट ऑप्शन
पेट बॉटल्स ऑफ मिनरल वाटर,
सेकेंड कीपिंग पार्क क्लीन, सेकेंड वन इज
कीपिंग पार्क्स क्लीन,
थर्ड वन इज
कटिंग आवर नेल्स रेगुलरली,
फोर्थ वन
so there is this is one symbol given in your book and I hope you all understand this symbol stands for what.
Fifth one, turning of unnecessary lights.
Okay,
these are the option given
and now see what other option given in the next column.
Reduce, recycle, reuse, clean environment, a personal hygiene.
Now see student,
match the following.
Okay,
pet bottles of mineral water, keeping parks
clean,
cutting our
nails regularly,
this is a symbol for,
and you have to identify this symbol stands for what.
Next, turning off unnecessary lights. So, and in the second column, it is given reduce, recycle, reuse, clean environment, personal hygiene. Okay, now let's see. Pet bottle of mineral water. So, what is the right answer? Think about it. See the message column and tell the answer. Okay. Now, see student, there, these are the three R's, reduce, reuse and recycle. Now see,
pet bottles of mineral water.
So, I have already told you, when you go to the market and buy some things in the bottles like jams and pickles, or even you drink a mineral water, so you can reuse these bottles. Instead of throwing this as a waste, you can reuse this. So, this stands for this. Keeping park clean. If the park is clean, then it means we are cleaning the environment. Okay. If the keeping park cleans, reduce, it will not come in this category, recycle, reuse, personal hygiene. So, keeping parks clean. So, right match the column for this is the, if you are cleaning the parts, it means you are cleaning their surrounding. So, it gives rise to clean environment. Is it clear?
Next, third one, cutting our nails regularly.
So, nails are the part of our body. And to keep ourselves fit and hygiene, we follow some personal hygiene habits. That we daily brush the teeth, comb the hair, cut the hair, always take bath, hand your wash before and after eating the food. So, and after taking the bath, always wear clean clothes. So, these all stands for personal hygiene. These all stands for what, student? These all things stands for our personal hygiene. If we follow this regularly, we can keep our self fit and healthy.
So, cutting our nails regularly, it comes in which category? It means we are talking about what? It means we are talking about the personal hygiene. Okay? Then student, this fourth, this symbol stands for recycle. This symbol stands for recycle. Okay? Because see, recycle, you can recycle, and the advantage of this by recycling the newspapers or ki recycling kar rahe ho, to number of trees are less cut. So you can, this symbol stand for recycle. Okay. And after that, turning off unnecessary lights.
So what if we, when there is no need of electricity, when there is no need of light in your room, in which you, no one is sitting in that room, so how you can save the energy? Jaise aap school mein bhi jab games period hai, assembly mein jaate ho, to assembly aapki kahan hoti hai? Assembly ground mein hoti hai, class mein to hoti nahi hai. So at that time, what we do? We switch off the fans and light to save the energy.
So turning off unnecessary light, it stands for
reduce. It stands for reduce. Okay, thank you, student.